Hey, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're having a great day, a blessed day, and getting 1% better than yesterday and breaking free from anything that's holding you back from having the best day ever and becoming the best version of yourselves. It's a process, but it's going pretty well. I'm feeling good. It's been a good day. It's been a good week. The sun is shining. No side hustling today with the kiddos. My wife is already back to work being a teacher. The girls go back Tuesday, so it's just me and them today. We went on a bike ride, got some donut holes. The diet is hanging in there. I've been a little too bad lately, but I have not missed a day working out in like 2 months. I'm doing what I got to do. I can do a little bit better, that's for sure. Last day of August, I can't believe it. Pumpkin spice coffee's on the way. Football's on the way. Leaves changing color. I'm ready for it. Bring it on. And bring on the rest of the day. The day's flying, I think, because I'm having fun. I can never even get it all in. But the topics that I want to talk about and get in today are first, chronic pain and finding comfort in the Bible. I was hurting yesterday pretty good. I also want to discuss my August 2023 side hustle income report. You guys know that's always one of my favorite topics to add up all of my hustle throughout the month and see where that puts me. And then the last part of this video, which I've already recorded, is going to be me testing out a new mic that I was able to plug into my laptop via USB. And that will help me when I want to stream, when I want to do maybe picture in picture or just record my screen, or if I want to do interviews with other content creators like Joel and Christy or Jan from NYC and Money Mom and Steve Young. It will help if I can actually have a microphone. And Jan had mentioned that to me before, so I finally got it. I do have a mic for this phone. I'm not sure how great it is, but I'm getting there slowly but surely with the technology. But yesterday, I was a hurting unit. And I do think a lot of it comes from my poor choices in my diet. I know that's not going to help the inflammation, but you know, I was hurting. I still worked out. I did leg day, which is even worse. Lower body exercises, and just my back was kind of on fire. And so I found a verse in the Bible that jumped out to me that actually made me feel real good. It's 2 Corinthians 1, 3 through 4. And the point of it is suffering gives us compassion for others who are hurting. And those who have suffered make the most effective comforters. And that kind of made some sense to me. Like, if I didn't suffer that body pain, or if I didn't suffer in any other ways in my life, if it wasn't hard, if it was too easy, I wouldn't have the compassion, and I wouldn't be as an effective comforter. And 2 Corinthians 1, 3, 4 basically says, Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles so that we may comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God. So those who have suffered make the most effective comforters. And it's not just, and that kind of made me feel a little bit better about the pain that I was going through or about the pain that I have gone through in my life. And the pains that I've overcome, I think people who also suffer too, they can connect with others who are suffering because they maybe want to see hope, that there's a light at the end of the tunnel. And I do want to talk more about stretching and diet and exercise and inflammation, because it's just not about being mentally free. It's not just about being financially free, but it's about being physically free too, and pain-free and fear-free. And as pain-free as we can get. And I want to deep dive into yoga and low back pain and my neuropathy in my feet, you know, and I'm doing neck releases every day. And this is stuff that I don't complain about. Not too much anyways, but it's stuff that we can overcome, and we can seek comfort through the Bible, and we can know that if we're suffering, we can help others. And what are other things that I have suffered or that I have had to overcome that might give a ray of hope to those maybe going through the same? Well, first is chronic body pain, neuropathy, debt. You know, there's a way out of debt. It's been done. Addiction. Overcome addiction. There's a way out. Laziness. I used to spend my days doing nothing. Lack of hustle. Side hustles have changed my life, as you'll see in the next section. Consumerism, I used to buy to make me happy, but there's a different way. Lack of purpose and a passion. Now my purpose is to be the best that I can be, to have the best day ever, and to inspire others to do the same. Diet and exercise. You know I'm working on it. It's I'm not totally free. It's JB Breaks Free, not JB Is Free. I'm getting there. I love my sweets too much, but I've worked out just about daily for the last couple months. That's through the body pain, which is not easy. Stretching and yoga, it's going to be so key. Preparedness, I want to be ready for emergencies. Desire is suffering in itself. Untamed inner dialogue. Once I realize the inner dialogue is not me, it's not you, those thoughts inside your head, that's just a thought loop. It can be tamed through meditation, through awareness. Setbacks, there's going to be plenty of setbacks on our journeys. We can overcome them. Rejection, whether it's personally or professionally, it can be overcome, can be overcame. I wanted to be a waiter at this place downtown, and they would not have me when I was probably really early 20s. And I had some friends that worked there, and they probably didn't want one more crazy friend in that group. But they passed on me in the draft, and I got scooped up by the restaurant that I've worked at for the last, 18 years, and I'd like to say that they missed out on a good server. Comparisons, the thief of joy. Those are all things that can be overcome, and I can comfort on that journey because I've had to overcome, or I'm still in the process of overcoming all of them. And if life was just a breeze, if I didn't have any of those problems, then there probably wouldn't be a JB Breaks Free. There wouldn't be this channel. I wouldn't have the lessons learned. So I take solace and comfort in the fact that through those lessons, I can hopefully inspire others. And now let's get to some fun stuff. My August 2023 side hustle income report. So it was a weird month. Only 5 income streams. What really cut it down is no Instacart at all. I did strictly Spark, Walmart. I'm liking it. It's kind of nice not having to shop. Of course, it's a little bit more driving. But I do like the pace of it. And I mostly like the pay of it. Boy, some we've discussed aren't great, but I do feel like it's less driving in a way, and it's more laid back. You're more outside. You're in your car. So we'll get through them. Receipt Hog, $5. That's an app that you can download, Receipt Hog. Take pictures of your receipts, you'll get money. Lawn mowing, I made $90. I could pay $30 to mow a lawn. I did it 3 times. Flipping, $1,282 profit flipping. That's incredible. Like, I've gotten over $1,000 twice. I've gotten over $500 a bunch. I mean, $100 to $200 would be astounding for me. But, that's just me going to garage sales. That's just me going to thrift stores and, start by getting rid of the stuff that you don't need in your house. It's a lot of fun. It's a good hobby. The thrill of the hunt. It's very rewarding. Number 4, Survey Junkie. It's a daily email I get that pays 10 cents. I don't do like the big long ones. But every day I take a 10-cent survey that takes about 30 seconds, and after 50 times, it adds up to $5. And finally, Walmart Spark Delivery, $1,259.87. So those are my 5 income streams. I didn't do Instacart, and therefore I didn't have as many receipts, so my receipt app income has gone down. I would also like to do more product tubes. I've been talking about this for a while. Download Product Tube. I think you guys will really like that app. Is another income stream, but if you add up my 5 side hustle income streams, it equals $2,641.87 outside of my main job. And if you were to times that by 12, it would equal $31,700. I mean, that's an income right there. And that's just on the side, outside of waiting tables, which takes the pressure off. Slow nights takes the pressure off. When I need time off, I don't get paid for it. It takes the pressure off being overstaffed. It takes the pressure off, oh, the restaurant being closed on Wednesdays. I had to do this because that was my path. I had to put myself in a position to be in the spot that I'm in right now. Okay, welcome to the final part of today's video. Thanks for sticking around. I'm excited to try out this new microphone. And then I was wondering what song to play with it and what to do with it. And then Cats in the Cradle by Harry Chapin jumped into my mind. A song that can hit you as a kid and a song that can hit you as a parent. I guess I never truly paid attention to the meaning of the song, which is a scary meaning in a way, about a father repeatedly not having enough time for his kids or his children, until it's too late, and then he wants to have time with the children, and the kids grow up to be just like him. I remember hearing the song, and you knew it was emotional, and you knew it was about your dad a little bit growing up, and then the end goes, grown up just like me, my boy was just like me. And I thought that was like a triumphant ending, right? The happy ending to the story. But as you can kind of see where the song goes, it's just, I think, a very cautionary tale of to not let work or anything get into the way of spending time with your kids, because that time is fleeting. And they, in turn, will take those lessons and apply it back to you and perhaps even their own kids. But it goes, my son turned 10 just the other day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today. I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay. And he walked away, but his smile never dimmed. He said, I'm gonna be like him. Yeah, you know I'm gonna be like him. And the kid still worshipped his dad, right? Smile never faded. I could tell my kids right now that I don't have time to kick their soccer ball with them, or I don't have time to play chess, or do a French lesson, or go for a bike ride. And I don't think they'd go upstairs and pout. They would do their own thing, and they'd still be the happiest kids in the world, and it would be, I'd be the one who would be missing out. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. When you coming home, Dad? I get that text now from the girls who have one of my old phones, and they can just like text grandmas. They can't get any internet or anything, but they can text us and send us pictures. And when I'm at work, they send me Notre Dame updates constantly and whatever. And then, the 3 or 4 times that I go out a year, I'll get the text, when you coming home, Dad? And I pride myself on not getting that text too much, especially like, sitting at a bar or this or that. When you coming home, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, right? I want to have that conversation the least amount of times that I can with my kids, and I prided myself on doing that so far. And I came home from college just the other day, so much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And that verse kind of hits me. The last verse is the kids turn 10, and my girls will be 10 October. And this verse, the kids go off to college, and I do have some friends already with kids going off to college. And I know that there's not always going to be bike rides. There's not always going to be wanting to play chess or swim or do French lessons. I completely get that in, 6 to 8 years,
it's going to be what I really want, Dad, is the car keys, and what I really want is to go for the rest of the night. And so I do think, Dally, that I got to get this time in now and not to waste a single moment with it. And then finally, I've long since retired and my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. He said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find the time. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids have the flu, but it's sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, grown up just like me, my boy was just like me. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, Dad. No, we'll have a good time then. We can have a good time right now. Let's not have a good time then. Let's have a good time right now. Break free from what's holding you back from having a good time right now. Don't waste the time with your parents, with your siblings, with your friends, with your children, and with yourself. Take advantage of every moment. Seize the day. This day will never come again. And so far, I've done a bike ride with the girls today, and they did mention they wanted to do a French lesson, and we're about to do that right now. I'll talk to you on the next video. Break free.